A typical home has thousands of lineal feet of cracks and gaps where water can infiltrate in. But critical to a home wrap's performance is how you install it. And with me today is Dean Whitehead, who's a product specialist with Hanson Marketing Services. Dean, tell us about how you install a home wrap.
Well, Steve, the builder's crew would want to start with the roll, plumb at the corner of the building, leave about 6 inches of overlap, staple it off down the building, leave about an inch of overlap at the foundation so that any condensate or water that gets behind the siding or brick would roll off the Tyvek and onto the foundation, not under the sill plate.
So you always start at the bottom?
Yes, very important. And then you would want to roll that Tyvek home wrap straight down the wall without skewing it, without getting wrinkles in it, so it's nice and even all the way down the wall.
How do you fasten it?
Well, Steve, I think the builder's crew should be using a cap nail or a 1-inch crown staple. And as they go around the house, they need to overlap the seams 4 to 6 inches. When they overlap a second story to a first story, again, 4 to 6 inches. When they go around a corner, leave another 6 inches of overlap so that you can join these up. You can use Tyvek seaming tape, and then we'll have a seamless envelope around the house.
So, Dean, I notice that you're taking a 2x4 and you're pushing that Tyvek flat into the corner.
That's important, Steve, because when a tradesman just takes the Tyvek around the corner and makes a radius in the Tyvek in the corner, then they'd have to come back later and cut that to apply their brick or siding next to it. And that's going to cause a breach, a leak, and we'll get a water in the corner.
I noticed that there's a different procedure for cutting around windows.
That's true. We used to do the X cut around windows, and now we have a different method where we cut the Tyvek flush along the header of the window so that we don't tuck the Tyvek in and perhaps port water back into the wall. And then we come straight down the middle and then to the lower corners of the window. We tack it to the inside of the jambs and over the sill, and then we continue on with taping and applying the Tyvek down the wall.
Dean, it looks like a lot of care is going into taping the seams.
That's true, Steve. You need to take care in taping the seams because that's where a lot of water gets in. If you don't overlap the seams properly, use an acrylic-based adhesive tape, it'll fuse the Tyvek to the back of the tape. We can get water in there. We can also get wind blow off. Taping the seams is a good building practice.
What do we do when we have a sloping roof or gable that intersects a vertical wall?
You can have step flashing at that intersection of the wall and the roof, and you need to take your house wrap and put it over the top leg of that step flashing so that the water will drain off of the home wrap and then out to daylight over the flashing.
What are your recommendations regarding tilt wall construction?
Well, Steve, when you frame the wall on the deck, you have to be sure that the builder's crew leaves enough Tyvek, approximately 12 inches or so, to overlap the rim joist and onto the foundation when that wall is tilted up.
What are your thoughts on how you seal the building wrap to the foundation?
Excellent way to do that would be with skip caulking, latex caulk along the foundation and smoothing your home wrap into that. And that way it'll allow for drainage at the weeps. Okay. A good building practice would be to inspect your home wrap job after it's up. Make sure you repair any cuts, tears, any openings around hose spigots, dryer vents, anything that protrusion through the wall, make sure you tape all seams.
So, Dean, what are the most common mistakes in this area?
Well, things that I see in the field, Steve, not wrapping gables, not taping seams, not putting the home wrap tight into corners so that it's a problem for the next trade that comes along. You've got to overlap the foundation. You've got to get around corners. You've got to staple these things off so it doesn't blow off. And you need to tape. You need to tape those seams.
Well, Dean, great information.
You're welcome, Steve.